Hello students, in this video I'll continue chapter number 7, getting to know about plants. In last video we had studied the flowering plants, about shrubs, herbs, trees, climbers and creepers. So children, today we'll study about stems. It's a very important part of the plant. Stem helps the water and minerals to go to the leaves. As the water is absorbed with the help of the roots, but stems conduct the water and minerals and send it to the leaves and other part of the plants, which are attached to the stem through narrow tubes. Inside them, very narrow tubes are present inside the stem, which are responsible for carrying water and minerals to the leaves. So here we can write few of the functions of stem also. Stem conducts water and dissolved minerals from roots to the leaves and other parts. Other function of stem is, stem also conducts prepared food from leaves to the roots and other parts. When the food get prepared in the leaves, then it is a function of stem to conduct the prepared food to all parts of the plant. Some stems are modified to grow underground and then food is stored. You must have heard about the few of the stems that we eat, like ginger is there, potato is there. So these are the few of the stems which we eat. Next part of the plant are leaves. So leaf is an organ of a plant. The part of a leaf by which it is attached to the stem is called petiole. So in the figure you can see very clearly, this part is known as a petiole, at which the leaf is attached to the stem. Next, the broad green part of the stem leaf. This whole part of the leaf is known as lamina, which is a very broad part and a green part of the leaf. Next, we are able to see here few lines. These few lines are known as veins. These are the veins of the leaf. And next we can see inside, that is in the middle, there is a thick vein which is known as midrib. It divides the leaf in two parts. See, this is a middle part is there where the thick vein is there. It is known as midrib. The design made by the veins in the leaf is known as leaf venations. So children, you must be able to see that the veins here are making few design. So this design is, which is made by the veins, is known as leaf venations. And if you have seen the leaves properly, then the leaf venations or the design made by the leaves veins in each of the leaf is different. So the leaves can be differentiated on the base of their venations. So this was the structure of leaf. And we know that the functions of leaf. Leaf is known as food factory of the plant, because the food is prepared in the leaves with the help of photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is the name of the process, and the materials or the requirement for the process of photosynthesis are carbon dioxide, water, chlorophyll, and in the presence of sunlight, food is prepared in the leaves. So that's why the leaves are known as a food factory of the plant. Next, let's discuss. So this was a structure of leaf. Next comes the venations. Now we were discussing that there are different types of veins present in the leaves. Now see what is that leaf venation, and it's very, very clear when you will see the diagram. Two types of the venations are there. One is a parallel venation and other is a reticulate venation. So children, you must go for the words first of all. As a word, parallel. Parallel means, this is a figure, this is a picture for the parallel venation. In the leaves of grass, or you must have seen the banana leaves, the veins are parallel to one another. So this type of venation, we can see here minutely that the veins are parallel to one another. These veins are parallel to one another. This is known as a parallel venation. Parallel, you know that the lines are, that do not meet. Am I clear? So in the leaves where the veins are parallel to one another, design is in such a way that the veins are parallel to one another, that is known as a parallel venations. Second type of venation is reticulate venation. If the design is net-like on both sides of the midrib, children, we have seen in the structure of leaf that midrib is a thick center vein which divides the plant. So this is a midrib. So on both the sides of midrib, there is a network of veins, which is known as a reticulate venation. If the design on the both side of the midrib is in such a way, that is a network structure is there, no particular structure is there, the veins are spread on the leaves randomly. This type of structure is known as a reticulate venation. So it's very, very important question also. So you can write it as a extra question that differentiate between a parallel venations and reticulate venation. Children, next is the process of transpiration. Again, it's very, very important process. Transpiration process, it takes place in the leaves. So this process says that water comes out of the leaf in the form of vapor. So this process is known as transpiration. We must have seen, we can perform one activity also for to see the process of transpiration. Water comes out of a leaf in the form of a water vapor. That process is known as transpiration. And through this process, plants release a lot of water into the air. So this process is known as a transpiration. So I think you are very, very clear that first of all, we have done the structure of flower, then structure of leaf, then the types of venations and transpiration. Next, we can see the process of photosynthesis. Children, these all are the parts of leaf, because transpiration takes place in the leaf, and photosynthesis, this process also takes place in the leaf. So you all are familiar by this process that leaves prepare their food in the presence of sunlight and a green colored substance which is known as chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is a green colored pigment which is present in the leaves, due to which the color of leaf is green. For this, they use water. Water is taken. You can see this arrow. Water is absorbed by the roots, and through the stem, the water reaches to the leaf. And carbon dioxide from the air. In the air, we know very well that the percentage of different gases are there. So the process, for the process of photosynthesis, carbon dioxide is used. And then sunlight that comes from sun. And when these all requirements are complete, then the process of photosynthesis takes place. During this process, what happens? oxygen is given out. During this process, when the food is prepared by the leaves, then what happens? The product formed is oxygen. And the food prepared by the leaves ultimately gets stored in different parts of the plant as starch. So during this process, two things are formed. One is the oxygen, as we know that we used to say that plants gives us oxygen. So that oxygen is formed during the process of photosynthesis. And second thing is there, the food prepared by the leaves that is sent to all parts of the plant, and extra food gets stored in the form of a starch. That we know already, that food get stored in the different parts of the plant. That's why we know that we can eat the different parts of the plant. Sometimes we eat the leaves, roots, stems, flowers, seeds. These all parts of the plant can be eaten. Okay, so this is the process of photosynthesis. Next, we'll study about the roots. Roots help in holding the plants firmly in soil. Their main function of root is to anchor the plant in the soil. It holds the plant in the soil very well. So these are the roots, different roots you must have seen of different plants. Again, there are different types of roots. We'll discuss the types of roots. So here are two types of roots. One is tap root and other is fibrous root. So tap root is a plant with a tap root system. It is the largest, more central and dominant root from which other roots comes out. So this is a primary main root is there in the tap root. From this tap root, another roots come out that are known as lateral roots. So this main root is known as a tap root, and the other roots which are coming out of it are known as a lateral root. On the other hand, we are having another type of root, that is a fibrous root system, which is usually formed by the thin, moderately branches, that there is a bunch of roots near the base of the plant. So in this figure, we can see this is the base of a plant, and a bunch of roots comes out from these plant, from the base of the plant. This type of root is known as a fibrous root. So in this way, we can differentiate between the tap root and fibrous root. So children, I think from the diagram, it's very, very clear to you. Or you can pluck any of the plant and you can see that roots of that plant. On the basis of these roots, we can differentiate between the different types of root, that is a tap root and a fibrous root. So next part, in the next video, we'll continue the next part of the chapter. Thank you.